my reaction to the remake of Psycho, please don't do it. If something's not broke, don't try to fix it.
They're going to get crucified.
Why wouldn't they want to redo that one?
If people want to see a Hitchcock film, then they should go back and watch the original Psycho.
You do not try to remake perfection.
We all go a little mad sometimes.
It's only a movie.
I was very surprised that they were going to do this. Because it is kind of sacred ground.
For people who live in the religion of film, this is like sanctimonious stuff. And so like you're messing with the Bible.
Hitchcock's Psycho is a work of art. The Mona Lisa is a work of art. David is a work of art. Van Gogh's paintings are a work of art. Why do you recreate a work of art? I don't get it.
This one's Sant. Heroic, I would say, act. I would say suicide.
Only someone as deranged and talented as Gus would think about doing this.
It's like Scientology. It's like some people are intrigued, some people are joining, some people are like totally like aghast that it exists, afraid.
I wish that they didn't think they had to do it. I think that there are too many filmmakers today who are recycling old ideas.
It's part of the whole postmodern sensibility of recycling, redoing, as if we have no new things to do, new subjects, new attitudes.
I think we're appropriating, you know, the legacy of a classic to say, yes, well, don't venerate these things too much.
As soon as he gets the rain up, we're going to put the mister on. We have to see how you like that effect.
The idea of even doing this came from having meetings with the studios and having them say, we do have some projects that you might be interested in doing. So, and they'd give me the list, they would send me screenplays. Within those lists were always like remakes of like one or two movies that they had in their library. If you wanted to remake a movie, you should remake a movie like Psycho. But when you remake it, you know, you could update it, you could make it in color, you could cast, you know, modern day actors to play the characters, leaving the script the same and leaving every shot the same. To me, remake meant to remake it, you know, it didn't mean like changing around, because then it wouldn't be a remake. I had gone off into some esoteric area that they had lost me by the time I'd said, keep it the same. As soon as they heard that, it was like, you know, what? And they would say things like, you mean every single shot, you know, and I say, well, yeah, you know, like basically, yeah, every shot, why not?
I like that. Is this still going on? Like this?
And they would go, I don't know if we'll be doing that anytime soon, that kind of thing.
There are many, many outstanding filmmakers, but there's only a very few, which Gus is one of, that could get away with doing something like this.
I know, it's like watching the old movie. I know that. I've done it before. I know. That's why I'm doing it.
You've never done it before.
I did an appropriation of a shower scene, yes.
I'm all out of my dandruff shampoo. Can I borrow some of yours?
I'm all out too, honey, but try this.
Psycho shampoo. It takes care of dandruff, and then some.
Years went by, and every time I came to Universal, they would say no. And then this year they said yes, because Good Will Hunting made a lot of money.
You are hearing about successful filmmakers all the time saying that they plan to do something challenging and radical once they've achieved success, but they never do. So this is one of the first times I can even think of a filmmaker making good on that promise.
As it sound maybe for purist offensive or whatever, I don't think so. I think it will be much more offensive if someone takes Hitchcock's script and makes something else out of it.
It seems like on the surface of the announcement of making Psycho, it's like, well, why would they do that? What was wrong with the first one? There's nothing wrong, except nobody goes to it.
Psycho? No, I never seen it, never heard of it.
Hitchcock, is that what you said?
I never heard of the man.
It hasn't the same currency in today's movie-going audiences. It's mainly people who are psychophiles.
Hi, guys. How are you? Nice to see you.
The way I feel about it is I'm very flattered, you know, and I know my father would be flattered that people want to remake his movies.
Right.
You know, I think it's wonderful.
But she's harmless. She's as harmless as one of those stuffed birds.
It was really hard for me to envision the character without envisioning Anthony Perkins. Vince was somebody that was completely conceivable as this character, yet didn't play into the original.
I never had a conscious thing of trying to make it the same or make a difference. You know, my first day I got a little overwhelmed just with the whole feeling of it all.
12 cabins, 12 vacancies.
Here I am checking this girl into my motel from this movie that has happened way before and I saw as a kid.
I had never even seen Psycho. I just wanted to work with Gus. Bathroom?
Mm-hmm. And if you want anything, just tap on the wall, because I'll be in the office.
Well, thank you, Mr. Bates.
Norman Bates.
How are they supposed to do it? Are they supposed to mimic the original people? And I said, no, I think you should deliver a performance of your own using the script. And, you know, you can refer to the original, but it has to be like a person, you know, rather than a sort of impersonation.
Two different actors, three different actors can bring for the same part completely different meaning.
I want to talk to Marion, and I want her to tell me it's none of my business, and then I'll go.
Bob.
Because there's no character there, virtually.
Right.
I'm exactly. Just decided to kind of make
but you
her aggressive.
Do.
I want to talk to Marion, and I want her to tell me it's none of my business, and then I'll go.
So what if we're poor and cramped and miserable? At least we'll be happy.
Some people said to me, you're in Psycho, what are you playing? I said, the boyfriend, John Gavin. And they were like, oh, that's kind of a doll. That's, he wasn't very...
Is Marion in trouble? What is it?
I don't really find fault with the way he did it at all.
Marion trouble, or what is it?
Let's all talk about Marion, shall we?
Martin Balsam was so fine in this role that it was daunting to me. We brought you every hat in the world.
I think the hat's a little too big.
Okay, we like this one a lot. First plastic hat I've ever worn. I feel like this definitely goes into Funkville. Hot enough for you?
I like that hat.
I trust you implicitly.
Hey, how you doing? Good to see you.
See you again.
The original Psycho is kind of a perfect thing that's wonderful. And that you hang on your tree every year. It thrilled me that students wanted to hear all about it. I thought all that was wonderful, but somehow it wasn't any longer terribly relevant to me. I hadn't seen it for maybe 30 years.
What a wild life. I feel like I'm in a kind of time warp.
Seeing my work brought to life again is an experience that I simply never expected. It does not come to screenwriters.
Is there any screenplay that has been remade? Very few. But Hamlet, many times. Othello, many times.
And they go, well, what about all the language? And I said, some really hokey language, old-fashioned language. And I said, well, okay, you change those.
Some of this sounds a little old-fashioned for some reason.
It's a transvestite.
Tranquilizes.
You'll swing. See, if it doesn't gel, it isn't aspic.
Not changing anything was making those words seem like they were said today, and it just creates a kind of different tweak.
Here is our illustrious and most fabulous DP, Mr. Doyle.
I probably wasn't allowed to see it as a kid. You know, I came from a very strict Catholic upbringing where anything that scared or intimidated children was thoroughly discouraged.
Chris is, of course, prepared to jump off the crane and handhold the scene, because that's what he's used to doing.
Well, you know, sometimes you handhold it, and sometimes maybe you add one more shot than was in the original, and this kind of stuff. So just keep on trying to, you know, just sneak that in and have Gus sort of sitting there, oh, no, here he goes again.
The opening shot was, it was going to be this, like, flying shot through the city streets, and then it was going to, like, go into a window. And at the time, I think that the technology was just very, very early, and today it's, like, something that's pretty common. We just sort of did what they said they were planning to do.
Okay, really?
I don't know if it was exactly like the shot that they had envisioned. They might have envisioned something else.
I mean, in the original, it just goes in. It sort of just stops here, but it's the 90s, so...
Mm-hmm.
It's the 90s.
Video. Action.
Scene actually that Viggo and I have is the toughest scene I think in the movie. doing a scene with somebody who's supposedly your lover, you try to find out who the heck these people are, and the truth is you don't really know. You just have to kind of determine it.
I hate having to be with you in a place like this.
She wants more. She wants more commitment in their relationship.
The emotions are essentially the same. Even if it's a little different, it's all right.
I don't want it to be any different.
You want it to be exactly the same?
Yes!
She's so not modern. So each time I kind of try to figure out where the hell it's going to make it modern.
It was really a long shot that we were going to change the house.
The original Psycho house is an icon. It's a character in the film.
Oh, you're changing it.
We're changing the house.
Gee. Sacrilegious.
The house is really where the exit.
Actually, it was an old plantation house in Mississippi. The kind of house that you would see in an English horror movie. Pretty scary.
So we just put the new one's facade in front of the old one. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. The energy of the old picture is sort of in back of it.
The motel's been renovated, and the sign says, the new sign says, Bates Hotel, newly renovated.
It looks like every hotel I've stayed in, but they're all kind of like that. Which is great, because people will, like,
relate,
check in.
If you looked at the original film and then looked at our version of it, you'd probably recognize the similarity.
At least for half of the audience or so, are they watching two movies at the same time in their mind? Are they really watching both movies, sort of making quick comparisons constantly?
There are quite a few visual references to the original in terms of set dressing and props. In Mom's room, the hands of Josephine.
The area that we deviate, and you have to because it's color film, it's not black and white, is in the lighting.
How are we going to make it our own? I think for my part, we made it our own by the color scheme.
The colors start fairly desaturated. The drama increases and the suspense, so do the colors. So when we reach the motel and the Bates house, that's when the really stronger colors are introduced into the movie.
Keep it professional. Don't cross lines. Keep it professional. Let's pretend that your parents are watching. Sherman, you're taking your hands and you're dipping them below the belt. Now, if you excuse me, because it does.
Let's talk haircut.
I don't know. You know what we can start with first, if you want? You see how this looks, Gus? Is maybe just clean up the sides here and leave a little on top. Should we go all the way bald?
No. That wouldn't work.
Are you getting me at all? Or am I like the weird kid that you're studying behind the glass?
What we're trying to do is test which shower curtain would look the best in the famous shower curtain for the famous Psycho.
Currently liking this one a lot. We can see through it, get a really funky geometric shape seeing through it.
Is the original shower still, the curtain still somewhere?
It's sort of a fantasy that everything from a movie is in some closet somewhere, but it's not. If it existed, it'd probably be all brown and crinkly and have chocolate syrup on it.
When I see the shower curtain, I pick the button for her dress.
That's the specialness of Beatrix, finding the buttons that match the damn shower curtain.
The biggest challenge is how we can keep the movie as it was, but make it in a modern version, and how the clothes reflect in it. We kept the same silhouette for the clothes, the tight, body-fitted clothes. That was back in the 60s, and maybe today is not so popular, so we kept pretty much close to the original images.
I guess I'll put this money in the bank and then go home and sleep it off. You can't buy off unhappiness with pills. Okay.
Come on up.
Terrific. This was a scene in the original Psycho where I was the other girl in the real estate office.
Teddy was furious when he found out I'd taken tranquilizers.
I'm Rita Wilson. It's very nice.
Oh, love you.
Well, I'm honored to be playing you.
Well, I'm honored you're playing me, but
Teddy called me.
And my mother called to see if Teddy called. I was like, okay, do you think my character is okay? Because it's so kind of different, I think, from what you're doing.
Wow. It's as hot as fresh milk.
Girls ought to get your boss to air condition you up. You can afford it today.
My sweet little girl.
That whole scene presents the catalyst for the whole change in the movie, and then plop comes in this thing that changes her life.
$400,000 cash.
No, I think I'm gonna go put this money in the bank, and then I'll go home and
Let's take it off.
I think a lot of viewers would have this thought if they were taking $400,000 to the bank for their boss. The identity of the audience, it's very curiously wrapped up in Marion.
She's excited about the money, 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 money. What if she was just dancing around?
She has a different kind of thrill in taking the money.
Fanning herself.
I mean, there's some things that are very much like the original Marianne, but then other things that are quirkier and more ditzy. It's almost like the audience's eyes. We're seeing her paranoid journey as if we are her. In Marianne's case, it's almost like she went to sleep that night and she dreamt that she did steal the money, and she dreamt that she went far away.
Quite a hurry.
James Remar plays the policeman. He was really interested in playing him like the original guy.
In quite a hurry.
But I think you go like you were doing.
Hey Gus, do you know what her license plate says?
Anal.
Damn it, you knew!
You just heard us yelling it.
That's a really good, easy one. Okay. Ask me some other trivia.
What's the 709?
I just got it. Well, I've only seen the movie once, though, so that's okay that I just got it.
There's an old saying, the first customer of the day is always the most trouble, but like I say, I'm in no mood for it, so I'm going to treat you so fair and square that you won't have one human reason to give me.
James LeGros was practicing it like the original guy, but then he added more of his own style.
Say, that's the one I'd have picked for you myself.
Yes, Mr. Lowry?
The things like rear projection, are we going to make it seem realistic, or are we going to let the rear screen projection be obvious? These kind of things were very exciting.
Becomes more and more clear that it's not necessarily ordinary logic. It's more the uncontrolled and symbolic logic of a nightmare.
Here. One is, this is the one where he comes back and she gets out of the car.
Make it rain, please. Make it rain. Action!
Okay, Bruce, cookies in the window.
Do I look like Gus when he did it? It's almost like a marriage speed.
No smiling, though. This is fake.
You guys don't.
She goes back in the car, yes. After she goes and looks at the side of the thing.
Oh, she does the horn.
She goes and gives the horn.
Vince, you're next.
I don't see him.
There he is.
But he doesn't have all those steps to run down, dude.
Yeah, he does. Watch. Did you see how he's kind of like jogging? Did you see that? Watch this right here. Watch where he is right here, Vince. Watch. He's bouncing.
But how come this has turned into an Olympics versus me and Anthony?
You don't have to run down.
I'm going
to
run.
All right, here we go. Let it down.
First day of this, I got very terrified. When all of a sudden you start to get really scared, but my body is fearful, but I'm not fearful, and I'm kind of happy to have this experience, but at the same time, this is interesting that this is happening to me. And I said to Anne, I said, I know it all and I see it all. And for some reason, I'm freaking out. And she said, you know, you have to trust where you're at. It will be perfect. I like that dress a lot.
Isn't this dress excellent? I like your suit.
But it's nice to have someone who you trust when it's like you're portraying a role that's been portrayed brilliantly before. Really, you know, put me at ease with it.
You're supposed to open the window.
It's stuffy in here.
And then you, kind of go like that. Over there.
And over here, like that, yes. Over there.
The bathroom.
I mean, I can't even begin to describe my first day, not really knowing what I should do, whether I should copy, you know, the way everything was edited originally. Yeah, it's a different way to edit a movie. I mean, we know that things are going to be a certain way, and I still have to go through all these bins and find the best pieces. You cut it together the way they originally had it, and then you kind of look at it and go, kind of slow.
I mean, Hitchcock was very, very methodical and puzzle-like with his pictures. So pieces of the puzzle can be put back together again by other people at other times.
I know that this same notion has been employed in other disciplines, like in painting and sculpture and even in music.
If you copied a painting and you figured out the type of oils that he used and you figured out his techniques, then you did it. It would pretty much be very close. I mean, that's how forgers work.
No, I wouldn't say so. You know, because the forger, it's wrong. Because the forger doesn't want to be found. This thing is signed by Gassman's son. It's repeating something and saying, look at it, I did it, not him.
It's sort of out Warhol.
I have a parlor back here.
Well, all right. Duh.
Sit down.
Do you want to have sandwiches with me because you're nice?
I want to have sandwiches with you because Mommy says it's bad and I won't be good.
He eat like a bird.
And I've never found an audience to even shuffle their feet during that very long scene. Scenes that long are very rare in today's movies. So it'll be wonderful to see what the audience reaction is.
Why the fuck do you have birds stuffed on your wall? Hello, psycho. I'll see you later, you stuffed birds.
All that dialogue is all very revealing if you know the story.
You are a wonderful person for me to have met, and I think I'm gonna go crawl back into my life that I had because it's a lot more interesting than yours.
You're not really gonna go back into your room, are you?
Yeah, I'm very tired, and I have a long drive tomorrow all the way back to Phoenix.
I think that as a viewer, you're sort of drawn in. It goes to these different levels until I'm just, you know, I'm a little sleepy, and it goes back to normal, and the audience is thinking, what was that?
I always feel that anybody who gets murdered was on the verge of doing something wonderful. That's the way I felt about her. She decides she's going to return the money, she's going to purify herself, and she goes in to take a shower, and somebody comes in and stabs her to death. The person you've been with from the beginning of the movie, and we've taken you all through these places that she's gone and these things that she's done. Now we've slashed her to death in the shower.
Good.
Look at that.
Gus?
Toast to the whole crew, an excellent crew, and on to the next week.
L'chaim.
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 And
action.
I felt that the cleaning up sequence should be a long one. You just were going to need time to understand that the star of the movie was dead. But you've already made a kind of switch over to him because you know that he's doing it to protect his homicidal mother.
So is Vince playing it fruity?
No.
Certainly never entered my mind that I was writing about a man who was gay. I think these kinds of things began to be said really much, much later when homosexuality was much more accepted. People go back over old movies and look to see what might have been a subtle implication because we couldn't do more. And lots of people find that, and I think it may very well be there.
The scene where I get killed, Norman's mother jumps out and slashes my face with a butcher knife. He looks like he's floating.
Yeah, that's the part I like about it.
Oh, you like that?
Effects guys hate that shot, you know, because you know their whole thing is doesn't look real.
Well,
but we of course like the fact that it doesn't look real.
I don't think Hitchcock was striving for realism the first time. Realism isn't the point. This is Arbogast's experience of dying. He feels himself sort of floating off into oblivion.
I mean, it is an effect, and it does look surrealistic.
Pretty much, if you see me in a movie, I'll end up dead by the time it's over.
You know what it's like? This in your head every night you're gonna go to sleep.
What the titles are supposed to do in any movie is lock your audience into the tone of that movie, and the tone of the main titles for Psycho is just really frenetic. What it does is it gets you in this kind of crazy way of thinking. Written in 2/4 time, which means that the bars go by incredibly fast. Bar, bar.
And when a musician sees 2/4, it usually means something vigorous. The original recording was a mono score. By doing it in stereo, you get it going boom, 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 boom.
I wanted to do a recording that was very close and dry and very aggressive to try to give you some of the feel of what the original did, blasting out of the speakers with no fidelity whatsoever, taking an old-fashioned approach and doing a contemporary recording.
As cinema grows older, it's only 100 years old. You know, the cinema of 300 years from now, these things will happen. And this can also be a way that we can learn to tell a story to, you know, people again.